Do not call to mind the former things. Pay no attention to the things of old. Behold, I am about to do something new. Even now, it is coming. Do you not see it? Indeed, I will make a way. Isaiah 43:18-19. This was the word God spoke to my heart, March 12, 2020. The shutdown, March 16, 2020. And 5 months later, hundreds of online classes later, we have 2 new locations, a vibrant internship and youth teaching program, and all new outreach projects. When God says He is doing a new thing, He means it.
Hi, my name is Christy Hernandez, and I'm the Executive Director of Dance for Joy Ministries. Welcome to Transformation 2020, a virtual benefit concert telling the stories of the transformative work God is doing in Dance for Joy.
Our mission is to train up the next generation to proclaim the gospel in dance. And this season of training has been one of deep humility, regrouping, picking up the pieces, rebuilding, and pressing forward. We press on to count it all joy. James 1:2-4. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. This is what you are going to hear from the youth of D4J today, how in their journey with the Lord, they are finding joy amidst the hardship, and they are pressing on to win the prize heavenward in Christ Jesus.
I'm Danielle Benson, and I was Christy's personal assistant for the summer. So the piece is Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus, right? And I feel like that's actually been the theme of the summer, because of amidst COVID and wearing masks and social distancing and everything, every day we took a day at a time. We didn't know it was going to happen tomorrow, so we just took that day. And I feel like that's actually just turning our eyes upon Jesus. I actually am thinking of when Jesus calls his disciples, he says, "Follow me," and they just dropped their nets and followed him. Jesus didn't give the disciples like a 3-year plan of his ministry, of a schedule every day, right? And so this summer was really us just saying, okay, being willing, being obedient, having our hands open to whatever the Lord wanted us to do. So that's really what it is, turning your eyes upon Jesus and following him. That's it. I hope they see Jesus. That's the best thing you could do when you're dancing for the Lord, is for them not to see you, but as an instrument for his glory. I want them to see Jesus in the piece. Katarina Ballsmith, she's my gal. Actually, it's been amazing. We've become, I would say, way better friends. Not that we weren't not friends, but to be honest, I feel much closer to Katarina after doing this piece. And so I feel like that's beautiful that a friendship has been able to also blossom while we choreographed together. So it's cool.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. Thank you.
learned this dance, Come Alive, originally with Jesse Hernandez and Anne-Marie Orchard. This piece has always been very powerful to me because I feel like it perfectly exemplifies the concept of how God works in all of us to breathe life into us. I feel like this piece has related to me both when I learned it originally and now. The piece is still very relevant to realizing how God works through me, through my dancing, and also just in my day-to-day life, how he is constantly breathing his life into me and using that to breathe life into others as well. I feel like the concept is still very relevant. You know, originally we learned it as a trio and we were all very close, so it was very fun to put it together with the three of us and to use it to spread a very powerful message. And I feel like it's still even more powerful now with six of us, more of us obviously, but also just dancing with people who I may not know as well, but we're still able to work together to deliver this message to the world in a time when a lot of people need to turn to God. And I feel like this dance is very helpful for that.
So much we have lost as we look down the road where all the prodigals have walked. One by one, the enemy is whisper lies and let them off as slaves. But we know that you are God, yours is the victory.
Also a dance instructor with Dance for Joy Ministries. And I'm going to be sharing my testimony of the dance that I choreographed called Shatter. When I was growing up, I started taking a ballet class at a young age, and I felt from the first moment of taking class that God was going to be using dance in his purpose and plan for my life. I also felt that the Lord was calling me to teach ballet when I was older, and also to be teaching other children to dance for His glory. Only in those moments I did not realize of the hardships that were to come and how dance would be used to break free from the suffering that I would face. When I was 13 years old, I started struggling with constant fatigue. During that time, I ended up going to many different doctor appointments, and they tested me for mono, which they believed that I had, but each test they did came back negative, and I still had no answers. My parents were constantly worried for my health, and it felt like I wasn't going to be getting better. And also during those 2 months, I missed several dance classes, as well as church services and other youth groups. And it wasn't until years later when the doctors finally realized what was going on and why I was feeling fatigued. Months later, I started feeling better, and even though I began feeling better physically, I still had fatigue. And I ended up struggling with more hardships in high school. That following year, I started struggling with depression at the age of 14, and it has continued on since. And the depression lasted for several months at a time, and I felt really discouraged in dance class, and I started comparing myself to others. And I also was told that I had some loss of strength in my feet, and that led me to feeling really discouraged. But because of the encouragement from my family and friends, I had continued dance even though I felt like I wanted to give it up. And that led me to this beautiful opportunity God had prepared for me to start taking dance classes with Dance for Joy Ministries. Everyone was really welcoming and encouraging right away. I made several new friends, and I enjoyed going to class. And even with all these new opportunities to dance, I still was struggling with fatigue and depression. And then, about a couple years later, during my senior year of high school, I felt like everything was coming into place. I got to start teaching with Dance for Joy Ministries. I started teaching a ballet class, and it was such a blessing to me because that was something I felt God wanted me to do since I was little. But even with the new opportunities with dance and getting to choreograph more, there were still hardships that I faced that year. I ended up feeling like the Lord wanted me to pray. It's one evening. So I ended up surrendering everything to Him, and I continued to tell God that no matter what was coming that year, I would continue to trust in His plan for my life. But in those times, I didn't realize of pain and suffering I was going to be facing. A few months after that prayer, I ended up finding out that my grandma had passed. And this was really hard on me because she was someone who was really encouraging and supportive with my life. She encouraged me in those times I didn't feel good enough in dance. And it was really hard for my family to lose her during that year. And it led me to dealing with depression, but also grieving for about 4 months. But over time, it started to get worse, and I started noticing I had nerve pain in my feet. And I didn't really think much of it right away because I was still in that grieving time over the loss of someone special to me. But then I ended up getting diagnosed just a few months before I graduated high school with an inherited peripheral neuropathy called Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease. And this disease, it affects the nerves, so you have problems with sensory loss in the nerves, but also muscle weakness. And the muscle will atrophy, and not only in the feet and the hands, but other parts so that there's nerve damage. And the hardest part for me is that this disease is progressive and there's no cure. So I had to learn how to deal with constant fatigue every day, but also constant pain. And because of these life changes, during that time I was still having year, I ended up feeling more depressed, and it got to the point where I almost quit dance. I felt that no matter how many times I would go to dance class, I would still feel really discouraged, and I was still struggling because of these new changes in my life and having to live with a physical disability. I began to feel self-conscious of this disability, and it led me to continuing to struggle. But even with these hardships, there is still hope, because I've had many different specialists and doctors and physical and occupational therapists who have continued to help me through the past couple of years. And I've had my family and friends and many people with my church and also with Dance for Joy who have continued to encourage me and uplift me in those times I did not feel good enough. Last fall, God gave me this beautiful vision of this dance that He wanted me to choreograph, a dance about brokenness and restoration, a dance that can not only share the testimony I have of this pain, but to encourage other people and bring hope to them even during times of suffering. Even though I've continued to struggle with pain, and I've continued to struggle with fatigue, I have changed my prayers. So instead of praying that the Lord would heal me, because He can, but I've decided to pray more for more opportunities to encourage others. So my hope, my prayer with this dance is, as you see it, you feel encouraged and know that even during times of brokenness, God is going to use that for a purpose. He's going to put those shattered pieces and create it into a beautiful masterpiece.
My name is Grace Cross, and I was the MC of Transformation 2019. I was a performer with Dance for Joy Ministries for 12 years, and now I am a student at the Academy of the Performing Arts at Huntington Beach High School as an acting major. Last year, I had the wonderful opportunity to be a part of a film that was inspired by a night which I fell on stage. It was the one and only time that I have fallen, and it was directed by a wonderful woman named Brianna Humble, who wrote a film script inspired by me. I would like to share with you this verse, which has been the inspiration for my life, and it reminds me a lot of the message of the movie. It is Romans 12, 9 through 10. Don't just pretend to love others, really love them. Hate what is wrong, hold tightly to what is good. Love each other with genuine affection and take delight in honoring each other. I hope you enjoy the film.
Thank you. Human hearts are often tender, and human minds can pity no. If human love is touched with splendor, and human hands compassion show. If we will often share our gladness, if we respond when children cry, if we can feel each other's sadness, each other's tears attempt to dry. If sometimes we can live for others, and sometimes give where gifts are spurned, if sometimes treat our foes as brothers, and love where love is not returned, then how much more shall God, our Father, in love forgive, our wants supply, and none deny.
Danielle, Mary, Katarina, and Grace are just four of the outstanding young people God has given us the privilege of training up over the last 13 years. They began just like the next beautiful dancers you're going to see.
A wonderful reminder of God's promise. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he gets older, he will not depart from it.
Thank you.
God finishes what he begins. Philippians 1, verse 6. I am convinced and confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will perfect and complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. We consistently challenge the dancers to believe and have faith that God will do what he has promised.
K-Classic.
Do marvelous things, even in a pandemic, we gained a new artistic director.
Hi, I am Susie Beck Gifford, and I am the new artistic director at Dance for Joy Ministries. When I moved back from New York and Christy asked me to become a teacher for her about 5 years ago, I was super excited. And being part of Dance for Joy, I just immediately from the very beginning felt welcomed and loved and appreciated. And you don't get that in every place that you go. And I've been very fortunate to teach in a lot of different places and to dance in a lot of different places. And there's just something really special about Dance for Joy Ministries. And every student and every faculty have just such a heart for the Lord. And it really puts a new perspective on dance. And I'm excited as this new artistic director to continue Christy's mission and to continue making every kid feel special when they come into the studio and when they leave the studio, so that we can continue just to praise Jesus with this beautiful gift of dance that he's given us.
We also gained a new place to serve, the OC Rescue Mission. June 1st through the 4th, three Dance for Joy teachers and three youth interns had a fantastic time sharing the joy of dance with the kids at the OC Rescue Mission.
Olivia.
Hello, my name is Isabella.
My name is Samia.
Dana.
Hi, my name is Miley.
My name is Carrie Dolman, and for the past two summers, I've been the summer events coordinator here at the Orange County Rescue Mission for the kids. And so the beginning of my experience with Dance for Joy was Laura gave me Christy's contact, and we had a conversation on the beach trying to organize the week. And I just felt the sense of we can do this. You know, there was knowing the population that we were serving. Christy had no doubt that we were going to be able to pull this off, and it really brought me back into it. I'm like, okay. From that get-go, the ball was just rolling in and all positivity. There was no slowing down.
It was really fun, and I loved all the teachers who teached us different types of style.
Yes. It made me feel like happy about myself, that I'm doing what I like again.
The whole dance camp, I was just amazed with the people she brought on.
They're gonna learn how amazing the teachers are and how amazing their dance choreography is.
All my friends were there. We got to dance and have a lot of fun.
And the kids, how they responded, all real tentative initially, and then just blossomed.
I felt kind of shy at first, but then when I got used to it, I did not.
By the time they got on stage at the end, I was just like, this is amazing what you can do from reluctance to complete buy-in.
I feel like it really showed how much we cared about it.
The dance, like the light shine bright, the elements of the song, and it's just like, it hit me.
I saw them on stage that last day, and I was brought to tears because of the synchronicity, because of the joy. You could tell it, moves weren't perfect, but that didn't matter, and they were just having a good time together.
I tried with my best, and it did not matter if I was good. I felt good.
You know, happiness and joy.
I'm able to show my mom that I could do it, like,
The feedback was just amazingly positive. I just saw the joy in the kids and the willingness to participate, because with this population, a lot of times you don't get that. You just kind of get a little distension from the troops, and that was really cool that they were able to, just with the music and the motivation behind their teaching, they really brought everybody in. I think just knowing a little bit about what they've been through, and being able to see the serenity and the joy that was brought through the performance and the music, like you said, it just, I think, lets them know right then and there, God is with us.
So how did God impact me? At first I didn't really want to, but I think God wanted me to do it.
To always think about, like, God and how he can, like, change the world and you.
He's very kind and generous.
And he can do amazing things with those who follow him. And they were willing to just give their all.
I want to say, don't give up. It's gonna be okay
to be happy and not give up on yourself.
Don't be scared, be brave, and do what's best for you.
You gotta learn and be brave, and you can't fall it down.
You should just try your hardest and believe in God.
It was very meaningful to me, because I was just like, wow, we can do this. We can work together, because so often they're not working together, and they were happy to do it. So hopefully we can do it again next summer.
projects like that and others were fully funded by a loving team of Champion Financial donors. For the last 13 years, Dance for Joy Ministries champions have been making it possible for all children in our local communities to proclaim the gospel in dance. We believe the lives of dancers and all who see them are being transformed for the glory of God through their generous support. A major part of that generous support this year is the two new partnerships God has provided for us in this new season. One with Arise Church Irvine, and the other with the Wilson Street Learning Center in Costa Mesa. These locations are the new homes of our classes, and they were also the hosts of our 2020 annual Youth Praise Dance Conference.
Signs of life, they're all around me. With every heartbeat I feel so alive. I am joy and sadness, peace and madness. If only I can fight just a little longer, I know it's gonna make me stronger. So I'll just keep holding on to what I believe. Oh,
so I've been doing YPDC since the very beginning, and it's always been a time to come and dance with my best friends every year, but it's always a time of like great growth, like challenging yourself and pushing yourself to your limits and further.
So this is actually my first year here, and it's really different because it's virtual and we're all spread apart, but we're actually together.
Every time I've gone to YPDC, actually I was a kid when it first began, so I was like 8-9 years old before we even started YPDC. So as a little kid, doing dance camp with Dance for Joy every summer always brought me joy.
So I've been doing the YPDC Dance for Joy as long as I can remember. And this year is different because we're in a different format, and while some of us are meeting in here, most of it's virtual. It's just a reminder that you have to root yourself and ground yourself before you can flourish.
Kind of taking, counting every blessing that we have.
I have been with the studio for about 8 years now. I'm now 18, so when I was 11. But my experience today was an experience that I haven't experienced in a long time for 12 years.
You can totally feel him, and there's a bunch of people on screen and they're all worshiping and there's dancing happening and there's people just like, I can like tell that people really feel the Holy Spirit, and I personally do as well.
That we're still able to have this connection of being able to have people who maybe can't leave the house for different reasons or in a completely different part of the world, but they can still partner and be with the ministry.
Everyone in the world right now might not feel love because they can't feel anything in their life. Their life hasn't been changed by God, by His love.
My hope that it will impact everybody around us, that each one of these peoples represent like a million people, because I believe that one person can change the entire world through Christ.
Having other people join us is such a fabulous thing, to be more diverse and to understand other people and for other people to see the joy that we have for the life we live.
I believe that people will walk in confidence, knowing that this person's walking in confidence. Oh, I can actually walk in confidence, and that makes me so much stronger in the body of Christ.
I was so hard on myself. I had to look perfect. I had to be, you know, skinny. I had to look the right, I just had to be a ballerina. I had to do the right part, right? And actually it was when I started to dance African that I realized I didn't have to be perfect.
As a dancer, it's not just about movements. Yeah, of course, about movements, about being passionate, right? But it's also about going to be honored with God, being there with God in His presence, doing what He wants you to do.
And forming a singular unit and really being one body of Christ.
Your heart, that's what matters. God doesn't care how high your leg is. He could, you know, it's great, but He's looking at the heart.
So they're going to feel loved. They're going to feel that there's something there that's always going to keep them together. It's always going to bring them up.
Don't be discouraged if you have stopped dancing or if you've never danced before. Do not be discouraged because God will definitely do something in you.
The youth you just saw are the faces of the next youth teachers and interns at Dance for Joy. As a result of our new partnerships in new locations, it is even more critical that our outreach be launched, expanded, and accessible to all. That's why we now have 10 new weekly outreach classes at the Wilson Street Learning Center that will serve up to 100 youth a week, grades kindergarten through high school. And every one of them needs a sponsor. As we all know, the current pandemic has thrown many children into crisis. They are in desperate need of social, emotional, spiritual, and physical care. Your generosity can make this possible. Through the weekly dance class experience, the Wilson Street Learning Center children will hear the gospel, feeding them spiritually, dance the gospel, strengthening them physically, be in a gospel-filled community, feeding them socially, and pray the gospel, lifting them up emotionally. These children need prayer support, volunteer support, and financial support. 100% of funding for their classes comes from people like you, recognizing that it will cost $240 per student to dance this fall season, which is $55 per month. We invite you to listen to this next psalm. Take time to see the words. Be silent, breathe, and be blessed. We also invite you to then take action. Go to our website and give what you can. Our homepage shows ways to give through prayer, volunteering, and financial support.
He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him I will trust. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare. My God, in Him I will trust.
Celebrate with us as we watch our D4J students light up the screen with Gaze of Elijah, our theme dance for the coming year, choreographed by our interns and youth teachers. Thank you again for coming to Transformation 2020. And if you truly enjoyed it, we hope you will share and send the concert to all your family and friends.
These are the days of Elijah. eyes of men, it seems there's so much we have lost. As we look down the road where all the prodigals have walked, one by one the enemy is whispered lies and led them off as slaves. But we know that you are God, yours is the victory. We know there is more to come that we may not yet see. So with the faith you've given us, we'll step into the valley unafraid. Yeah. As we call out to dry bones, come alive, come alive. We call out to dead hearts, come alive, come alive. Up out of the ashes, let us see an army rise. We call out to dry bones, come alive. God of endless mercy, God of unrelenting love, rescue every daughter, bring us back the wayward sons, and by your spirit breathe upon them, show the world that you alone can save.
Of God, now breathe, breathe, oh breath of God, now breathe, oh breath of God, breathe, oh breath of God, now.
Come alive.